we are starting with the new method, that is weighted geometric mean. So weighted arithmetic mean in the previous class we have studied. So next is the weighted geometric mean. So I've written the question here. Items we have up to E. Then weight is given in terms of percentage. That means the total of the weight value will be 100. The percentage total is 100. So we need not add the W values. So directly we can write it as 100. Then price values are given, base year and current year. So base year price is denoted by P0 and current year price is denoted by P1. So in place of base year price, we are going to write it as P0. Current year price, it is P1. So price is denoted by the symbol P. For the base year, it is 0. For the current year, P1. After P0 and P1, first we'll write the formula of the geometric mean. What is the formula? P01 equals anti-log of sigma W log P divided by sigma W. So we need log P. For that, first P should be found out. What is P? P is nothing but price relative. And how do we find out price relative? It is P1 divided by P0 into 100. So first we are going to find out the price relative, then log P. For the first item, P1 is 90, P0 is 100. So 90 divided by 100 into 100 will get 90. Then 20 divided by 20 into 100, it is 100. Next is 60 divided by 70 into 100, 85.71. Then 15 divided by 20 into 100, 75. 55 divided by 40 into 100, 137.5. So after P value, we have to find out log P. The first value is 90. So 90 is a two-digit number. So 2 minus 1 will get 1. So the value will be 1 point. Then under the logarithm tables, you have to see the value for 90 under 0. Either use the logarithm table or the scientific calculator. So we'll get 9542 when we see the value for 90 under 0. Then next is 100. 100 is a 3-digit number. So 3 minus 1 will get 2. So 2 point, see the table value for 10 under 0. Which is 0000. Then 85.71. 85.71 is a 2-digit number. So 2 minus 1 will get 1 point. Then see the table value for 85 under 7. We'll get the value 9330. And in the same value for mean difference 1. For mean difference 1, the value is 1. Add this 9330 plus 1 will get 9331. So the answer is 1.9331. Then next, 75. 75 is a 2-digit number. So 2 minus 1 will get 1. So 1 point. See the table value for 75 under 0. You'll get 8751. Next is 137.5. 137.5 is a 3-digit number, so 3 minus 1 will get 2, so 2 point. 13 under 7, mean difference 5. 13 under 7 is 1367, mean difference 5, it is 16. Now add this, so 7 plus 6, it is 13, 1 carry up. 1 plus 6 plus 1, 8. 3 and 1 will write as it is. So we are getting the total 1383. So the table value for 137.5 is 2.1383. So when you are seeing under the logarithm tables, maybe the last digit number, it might vary when you are seeing under the scientific calculator. Even if it varies, then no problem, your final answer will not change. You can go ahead with the scientific calculator calculation itself. After log P, we have to multiply W and log P. So what is the first W value? 30. So 30 into 1.9542. So we are getting 58.626. Then multiply the next one. 15 into 2.00. It is 30. Next, 20. So 20 into 1.9331. We'll get 38.662. Next W value is 10. So 10 into 1.8751. It is 18.751. And the last value is 25 into 2.1383. We'll get 53.4575. Now add all the W log P values. What are the values? 58.626, 30, 38.662, 18.751, 53.4575. And the total is 199.4965. 199.4965. Then substitute in the formula. We'll get anti-log of sigma W log P value is 199.4965 divided by W total is 100. So you have to divide this 199.4965 and 100. We'll get anti-log of 1.9949. So I'm writing only four numbers after the decimal point, because beyond that we cannot see the table value. So now under the anti-logarithm table, see the value for 0.99 under 4, mean difference 9. So 0.99 under 4 is 9863, and mean difference 9, the value is 20. So you'll get 9883. And you have to mark the decimal. For marking the decimal, we have 1 here. You have to add plus 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. So from the right hand side, after 2 digits, you have to mark the point. So it is 98.83. So the answer is 98.83. And you need not write the conclusion for this. For geometric mean, there will be no marks for the conclusion. We'll move on to the next problem. Again, it is calculate weighted geometric mean, price index number. So items we have up to C. Price is divided as base year and current year, and weight is given. So weight, it is denoted by the symbol W. Price of base year is denoted by the symbol P0. And price of the current year is denoted by the symbol P1. Next, we have to calculate the price relative. P equals P1 divided by P0 into 100. So calculate for the first item. What is the first item? P1 value 25,000. P0 is 20,000. So 25,000 divided by 20,000 into 100. It is 125. Next, 20,000 divided by 15,000 into 100, 133.33. And I'm taking here after decimal only one number, because totally only for the four digits you can see the logarithm tables. Beyond that you cannot see it. So I've taken 133.3. Totally four numbers. Next, 800 divided by 500 into 100. 160. Next column, log P. See the table value for 125. 125 is a three digit number, so 3 minus 1 will get 2. So 2.2 Then say the value for 12 under 5. It is 0969. Next is 133.3. Again, it is a 3-digit number. So 3 minus 1, we are going to get 2. So 2 point, see the first two numbers, 13. 13 under 3, mean difference 3 you have to see. So 13 under 3 is 1239. And mean difference 3 is 10. So you'll get 1249. 2.1249. Then 16 under 0s. 160 is a 3-digit number, so 3 minus 1, 2. So 2.16 under 0 is 2041. Then multiply W and log P. So W log P is 30 into 2.0969. It is 62.907. Then 50 into 2.1249, 106.245. Then 20 into 2.2041, 44.082. Now add the W log P values, which are 62.907, 106.245, 44.082. You'll get 213.234. This is the total of W log P, and we need the total of W, 30, 50 and 20, which is 100. Now write the formula first. P01 equals anti-log of sigma W log P divided by sigma W. I'll repeat it. Anti-log of sigma W log P divided by sigma W. Then we have to substitute under this. So we'll get anti-log of 213.234, which is sigma W log P total. And the total of W is 100. So divide, we'll get anti-log of 2.1323. So after decimal, we have to take four numbers in this so that we can see the table value. Now see the table value for 0.13 under 2, mean difference 3. So 0.13 under 2 is 1355 and mean difference 3 is 1. So we'll get 1356. And we have to mark the decimal. So before the decimal, we have the number 2. For this, 1 should be added. 2 plus 1 will get 3. So after, from the right hand side, after 3 digits, you have to mark the point. So 135.6. So the answer for the geometric mean for the particular problem is 135.6. We'll move on to the next one. Calculate weighted geometric mean price index numbers. So weight is denoted by W. Your price, we have two prices, 2018 and 2020. So 2018 is the base year, 2020 is the current year. So 2018 price is denoted by P0, 2020 price is denoted by P1. Next, we have to calculate price relative P, which is P1 divided by P0 into 100, then log P, then W log P. So the three columns we have to calculate. So first we'll do with P, that is price relative. So what is the first P1 value for the item A? 222 divided by 120 into 100. It is 185. Then second one, 80 divided by 40 into 100. 200. 300 divided by 100 into 100. 300. 200 divided by 100 into 100, 200. Then 500 divided by 300 into 100, we'll get 166.66. I am taking it as 166.7. Totally four numbers I want to take in. So because of that, I'm taking it 166.7. No problem if you take 166.6 also. If you take, your final answer will not vary. Only the point difference will be there. Even then, we'll give the marks. So if you know to approximate, approximate. Otherwise, take the same number itself. Then log P. So 18 under 5, 3 digit number, so 3 minus 1, we'll get 2 point. 18 under 5 is 2672. Then 200 is a 3 digit number, so 3 minus 1, 2. So 2 point, 20 under 0, 3010. We have one more 200 value, so we'll get the same thing, 3010. Log 300 is a 3 digit number, so 3 minus 1 will get 2. So 2 point, see the table value for 30 under 0, which is 4771. Then last one, 166.7 is a 3 digit number, so 3 minus 1, 2. So 2 point, see the table value for 16 under 6, which is 2201. And mean difference 7, it is 18. So add this, we'll get 2219. So write down the value here, 2.2219. Next we have to multiply W and log P values. What is the first W value? 25. So 25 into 2.2672. 25 into 2.2672, we'll get 56.68. Then next 10 into 2.3010, it is 23.010. 15 into 2.4771, 37.1565. Again we have 10 into 2.3010, so 23.010. Then last 150 into 2.2219, which is 111.095. So now add the values of W log P. So W log P values are 56.68, 23.010, 37.1565, 23.010, 111.095. So the total is 250.9515. So we have got the total of W log P. We need the total of W. It is 110. Now substitute in the formula. P01 equals anti log of. So first the formula, then substitution. Sigma W log P divided by sigma W. So anti-log of 250.9515 divided by 110 will get anti-log of 2.2813. Now see the table value for 0.28 under 1, it is 1910, and mean difference 3, it is 1. So 1910 plus 1 will get 1911, and here we have got 2, so 2 plus 1 will get 3. From the right hand side, after 3 digits we have to mark the point, so 191.1. So the answer is 191.1. We'll start with the next one. So here we'll do both the methods, that is weighted arithmetic mean and weighted geometric mean. So items we have up to E, then weight is already in terms of W, then price we have 2000 and 2001. So 2000 is the base year and 2001 is the current year. So base year is denoted by P0 and current year price is denoted by P1. Then first we need to calculate the price relative. P equals P1 divided by P0. Into 100. So we'll write down what all should be calculated. First the table part, then we'll calculate it. So since we are doing even the arithmetic mean, we have to multiply W and P. So before that we'll write log P. then multiply W and P, then multiply W and log P. So this four columns should be needed to do both the methods, that is arithmetic mean and geometric mean. So first is the price relative. So 110 divided by 120 into 100 will get 91.67. So again here I have approximated for the two digits. After 0.2 digits, then 24 divided by 24 into 100, it is 100. 75 divided by 84 into 100, 89.28. Then 20 divided by 24 into 100, 83.33. 65 divided by 50 into 100, 130. So now see the logarithm value. So 91.67 is a two-digit number. So 2 minus 1 will get 1. So 1 point. See the value for 91 under 6. 91 under 6 is 9619. Mean difference 7 is 3. So 9619 plus 3, you'll get 9622. So the value is 1.9622. Then 100 is a three-digit number, so 3 minus 1 will get 2. So 2 point. See the table value for 10 under 0, will get 0000. Then 89.28 is a two-digit number, so 2 minus 1 will get 1 point. See the value for 89 under 2. 89 under 2 is 9504. Mean difference 8, you have to see, it is 4. So 9504 plus 4 will get 9508. So the value is 1.9508. Then 83.33, again it is a two-digit number, so 2 minus 1 will get 1 point. 83 under 3, mean difference 3. It is 9206 plus 2. We'll get 9208. So 1.9208. Then 130 is a three-digit number. So 3 minus 1, it is 2. So 2 point. See the value for 13 under 0. We'll get 1139. Then multiply W and P. It is 30 into 91.67. It is 2750.1. Next is 15 into 100, 1500. Next 20 into 89.28, 1785.6. Then 10 into 1.9208, 10 into 83.33, 833.3. And the last one, 25 into 130, 3250. Now add all these values, that is 2750.1, 1500, 1785.6, 833.3, 3250. We'll get the total 10,119. Then we have to multiply W and log P values. So first is 30 into 1.9622. The value is 58.866. For the second one, 15 into 2.0000, it is 30. Then 20 into 1.9508, 39.016. 10 into 1.9208, 19.208, then 25 into 2.1139, 52.8475. Add all the W log P values. The values are 58.866, 30, 39.016, 19.208, 52.8475. We'll get the total 199.9375. So we have WP total and the total of W log P. We need the total of W. So the total of W is 100. Then first do it by geometric mean. It is anti-log of sigma W log P divided by sigma W. So anti-log of W log P total is 199.9375 divided by W total is 100. So we'll get anti-log of 1.9993. So totally I've taken only 4 numbers. So you have to see the table value 4.99 under 9, mean difference 3. So 0.99 under 9 is 9977 and mean difference 3 is 7. Now do this total, we'll get 9984. We'll get 9984 and we have to mark the decimal. So 1 plus 1 will get 2. From the right hand side, after 2 digits, we have to mark the point. So 99.84. So this is regarding the geometric mean. Now we have to do it by the arithmetic mean method. So what is the arithmetic mean formula? P01 equals sigma WP divided by sigma W. Previously I have used it as PW. Whether you use WP or PW, both are same. So sigma WP divided by sigma W, it is 10,119 divided by 100. We'll get 101.19. So the geometric mean value is 99.84 and arithmetic mean value is 101.19. While doing the unweighted method, I've said that always the arithmetic mean value will be more when compared to that of geometric mean, because arithmetic mean gives greater weightage to bigger items. So you can compare here, arithmetic mean value is more. It is 101.19 when compared to that of geometric mean. The value is 99.84. So this is regarding the weighted mean problems, weighted price index number. In the next class, we'll go with the weighted aggregative method, which you'll be having it in 10 marks, maximum times for 10 marks, and we can have the same problems for the 5 marks. That will continue in the next class. Thank you.